गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ एसपी. लास्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 7. शेयर कैपिटल एंड टाइप्स ऑफ शेयर. शेयर कैपिटल एंड टाइप्स ऑफ शेयर. Now, first of all, meaning of share capital, we have already done in OC subject, meaning of share, then different types of share we have done. Share capital means the total amount which company is going to arrange through or by issuing share. For example, if company is going to arrange total 1 lakh rupees, 1 lakh rupees. And they are going to arrange this money by issuing share, so it means this is share capital. Once again, the total amount which a company is going to arrange by issuing shares is called a share capital. Now, what is share? Share is the smaller part of total share capital. For example, if company has divided this 1 lakh rupees in means their smaller part is 10 rupees, it means total parts become 10,000. Each part is of 10 rupees. So 10,000 into 10, it becomes 1 lakh rupees. Means this 10,000 parts, part is known as share. Part means share. So company has divided 1 lakh rupees by 10, it means they had divided into 10,000 parts and each part is of 10 rupees. Now, technical language, they had divided 1 lakh rupees into 10,000 shares. Instead of part, now I am using the word share. And each share is of face value. This is called face value. Face value, or another name is nominal value. Nominal value. This is called a share. Then they are issuing shares. The person or the investor who purchased share, we all know that they are called shareholders. And shareholders, now share is also two types: equity shares and preference shares. Equity shares and preference shares. We all know the difference between equity share and preference share. Equity shareholders are true owner of the company because they are taking risk. So all these things we have done in OC subject also. Now, page number 127, share capital and types of share. Meaning of share capital is given and meaning of share is given. So we have done. Now come on page number 128. Definition I am reading once again, only for formalities, otherwise we have already done. In general terms, proportion of owner's capital is large, means share capital is large amount and which is divided into smaller parts. This smaller part is known as share. So smaller part of share capital or total share capital is called share. This smaller part is known as share. Share means shareholders' implacable interest in company. Share means implacable interest in monetary terms, means by purchasing share, shareholders are investing money into the business. Why? In order to earn fair return, and that fair return is called dividend. So in order to earn a dividend every year, shareholders are investing money. Next, definition: as per the Companies Act 2013, share means one part of total share capital, which also includes stocks. So simple definition you have to learn, that a smaller part of share capital is called share. Now characteristics of share we have already done in OC, and here characteristics of share in SPCC, it is deleted from the course according to new guidelines. Then types of share capital and characteristics of share is deleted, but we have already done in OC. Now types of share capital, this is also deleted, but this is important topic, that's why I am explaining, otherwise it is deleted portion. Types of share capital, right now I am explaining types of share capital, but before that, on page number 129, types of share, equity share, preference share, equity share and preference share we have already done in OC. That is also deleted portion. Then preference share characteristics, deleted portion. Then distinguish between equity share and preference share we have already done in OC. In SPCC, this is deleted portion. Then share certificate, deleted portion according to new guidelines. Direct you have to do 7.7. 7.7, page number 132. Page number 132. Only one topic is there in this chapter, 7.7, that is dematerialization of share. Then after that, 7.9 is deleted from the course, 7.9 bonus share, and last one is 7.10 right share, that is also deleted. 7.7 you have to do and 7.8 you have to do. 7.8, only two exercise, 7.7, 7.8. Otherwise, 7.4, 7.3, 7.2, 7.1, all are deleted from this chapter. Only two topics, 7.7, page number 132, and 7.8, various ways to issue share, 133. Two topics you have to do, but only for your knowledge, I am explaining one topic, that is types of share capital. This is important portion, but it is deleted from the course. Types of share capital, only for your knowledge, types of share capital. Now suppose company is issuing, I am taking one example, company is issuing 10,000 shares and each share is of 10 rupees. This is called face value, this is number of shares. And if you multiply 10,000 into 10, it becomes 1 lakh. This is called share capital. 1 lakh is the share capital. 10,000 is number of shares. The face value of each share is 10 rupees. Now how shares are divided into different types. Suppose company is demanding this 10 rupees in 3 different installments. And first installment is called application money. Right now you are not required to understand what is application money, what is allotment money, just try to understand that this is first installment, application money. Suppose first installment is of 3 rupees, second installment is called allotment money, allotment money, this is second installment. For your knowledge, I am taking here first installment, second installment, that is of 4 rupees, and third installment, that is called for final call, first and final call, this is of 3 plus 4, 7 plus 3, 10. The total company is demanding 10 rupees in 3 installments. First installment is of 3 rupees. Suppose I had purchased whole 10,000 share, it means I have to pay first time 10,000 into 3, 30,000, then 10,000 into 4, second time I have to pay 40,000. And last time 10,000 into 3, 30,000. So 30,000 plus 40,000 plus 30,000, it becomes 1 lakh. Means I am the shareholder and I have to pay 1 lakh rupees in 3 installments. Now try to understand types of share capital. First one is authorized capital. Authorized capital. Once again, this portion is deleted from course in SPCC, but then also it is very important. It will come in 12th also. Authorized capital. Authorized capital is also known as nominal capital. nominal capital. It is also known as registered capital. Registered capital. Now, what is authorized capital? Authorized capital is that amount, that total share capital. Beyond that, they cannot issue shares. Authorized capital is the maximum limit for the company. Only up to that amount, they can issue shares. For example, here their company is issuing 10,000 share, but suppose if authorized capital is 3 lakh rupees. 3 lakh rupees. This is the authorized capital. It means this is the maximum amount for which company can issue shares throughout their life. Company अपने पूरे जीवन में सिर्फ maximum 3 लाख रुपए के लिए शेयर issue कर सकते हैं maximum. Not more than 3 lakh they can issue shares. They can issue shares maximum for 3 lakh rupees. This is called authorized capital. They can also issue shares for more than 3 lakh, but for this purpose, they need to fulfill the formalities again. They need to take the permission of SEBI. They need to take the permission of central government. Means by fulfilling all formalities once again, then they can extend this amount. But once 3 lakh is registered, it is already published in the prospectus. That's why throughout their life they cannot issue shares more than 3 lakh. This is called authorized capital, registered capital. This is already mentioned in the prospectus at the time of issuing share. This amount is already mentioned in the memorandum of association, in the article of association. Because it is registered in the memorandum of association, that's why it is called registered capital. So not company cannot issue shares more than 3 lakh. This is called authorized capital. So in our example, authorized capital is, suppose share face value share is 10, so 30,000 share is the authorized capital, 30,000 shares. Now second one is issued capital is that issued capital is that amount for which company is issuing share. For example, in the current year, out of 30,000 share, company is issuing 10,000 shares. Means company is arranging how much? 1 lakh rupees. In order to arrange 1 lakh rupees, they are issuing only 10,000 shares out of total 30,000 share. So whatever number of shares they are issuing in the market in order to raise fund, that is called issued capital. So in our example, issued capital is 10,000 shares. And face value of share is 10 rupees. Total it becomes 1 lakh. Now company has issued 10,000 share in the market. Now after reading the prospectus, it depends upon investor whether to purchase a share or not. Suppose all investors have purchased only 8,000 shares. Out of 10,000 shares, investors has purchased 8,000 shares. The shares which are purchased by shareholder, that is called subscribed capital. Subscribed capital. So in our example, subscribed capital is 8,000 shares. And what about 2,000 shares? It remain unsold. That remains unsold. Now 8,000 shares out of 10,000 shares, investors has purchased 8,000 shares. It may be possible that company is issuing 10,000 shares and all the shares are purchased by investors. In that case, subscribed capital is also 10,000. But in our example, I have taken 8,000. So 8,000 is the subscribed capital. Means the capital, the shares which are purchased by investors is called subscribed capital. Now, subscribed capital means the number of shares which are purchased by shareholders. Now, the person who becomes shareholder has to pay these three installments. Three installments means total they need to pay 10 rupees in three different installments. After subscribed capital, fourth one is called up capital. Now what is called up capital? Called up capital means when company is demanding these three installments from investors. Suppose company has sent, first installment is already paid by the investors. It is compulsory to pay the first installment. Then only company will give you shares. So this is not called up, this is already called up capital as well as, this is called up capital as well as paid up capital. मतलब ये पैसे आपसे मांगे भी थे और आपने ये पैसे दे दिए. नाउ व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल मीनिंग ऑफ कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल? आफ्टर दिस फर्स्ट इंस्टॉलमेंट, वॉट एवर अमाउंट कंपनी इज डिमांडिंग फ्रॉम यू, कंपनी सेंडिंग यू लेटर टू द मीन्स सेंडिंग टू लेटर टू द इन्वेस्टर्स, टू डिफरेंट इन्वेस्टर्स टू पे सेकेंड इंस्टॉलमेंट मीन्स 4 rupees. तो टोटल कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल बिकम्स 3 + 4 = 7. तो वॉट एवर अमाउंट कंपनी इज डिमांडिंग, वॉट एवर अमाउंट कंपनी इज डिमांडिंग फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टर्स on the basis of installment, that is called called up capital. For example, after paying 3 rupees by the investors, company has demanded 4 rupees, means second installment. It means up to this level, total called up capital is 8,000 shares into 3 + 4 = 7. Means called up capital is 56,000. Now, fifth one is, कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल डज नॉट मीन दैट शेयर होल्डर हैज पेड द अमाउंट. कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल का ये मतलब नहीं होता है कि इन्वेस्टर्स ने उतने पैसे दे दिए. कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल का मतलब सिर्फ यही होता है कि इतने पैसे कंपनी ने अभी तक इन्वेस्टर से मांगे. 3 rupees तो सभी देते ही है, इसके बाद कंपनी ने 4 rupees मांगे, यहाँ तक मांगे वहाँ तक टोटल कितना होता है 7 rupees. दिस 7 rupees इज द कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल. नाउ आउट ऑफ कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल जो पैसे मांगे कंपनी ने, allotment money is of 3 rupees and allotment, sorry, application is of 3 and allotment is of 4. ये पैसे जो first installment है वो हमेशा paid होते हैं investors के द्वारा, क्योंकि जब paid नहीं करेंगे तो उनके application को consider नहीं किया जाएगा, इसलिए ये तो payment होता ही है. अब ये company ने मांगा है तो it may be possible that some shareholder will not pay, they are not able to pay the amount, they are passing through financial, they had purchased the share but at the time of second installment few shareholders are passing through financial problem, their income becomes low, they are not in a position to pay the second installment, it may be possible. तो ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है कि 10,000 शेयर लोगों ने खरीदे हैं तो सभी लोग ये पेमेंट कर सके. तो जितना पैसा कंपनी के पास यहाँ पे आता है दैट इज कॉल्ड पेड अप कैपिटल, पेड अप कैपिटल. अब हमारे एग्जाम्पल में टोटल 8,000 शेयर लोगों ने खरीदे हैं और कंपनी ने अभी तक 2 हफ्ते मांग लिए, 3 और 4 = 7 मांग लिए, दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड कॉल्ड अप कैपिटल, मीन्स दे आर डिमांडिंग 56,000. सपोज आउट ऑफ 8,000 शेयर लोगों ने कितने शेयर खरीदे, 8,000 शेयर, उसमें से सपोज करो मैंने 400 शेयर खरीदे 400 एंड आई एम नॉट इन अ पोजिशन टू पे सेकेंड इंस्टॉलमेंट मीन्स 4 rupees. तो 400 × 4 = 1,600. इसका मतलब टोटल जो अमाउंट कंपनी के पास आना चाहिए वो है 56,000 एंड आउट ऑफ 56,000 आई एम नॉट पेइंग 1,600 rupees. तो इस 1,600 को अगर हम माइनस कर दें तो जो पैसे कंपनी ने रिसीव किए दैट इज कॉल्ड पेड अप कैपिटल, मींस टोटल कंपनी हैज़ टू रिसीव 56,000 माइनस 1,600, 4,400 is the paid up capital. So authorized capital, issued capital, subscribed capital, called up capital, paid up capital. Authorized capital in our example, this is 30,000 share, means maximum company can issue 30,000 share. But right now company is issuing only 10,000 share. This is called issued capital. Then out of 10,000, investors has purchased 8,000 shares. Means the investors are promising to pay 8,000 into 10, 80,000. And this 80,000 investors has to pay in 3 installments. This is called subscribed capital, means capital or share which is purchased by the investors. Called up capital. Called up capital is that amount which is demanded by the company. In our example, company has demanded allotment money, means up to this amount. So 3 + 4 = 7. Called up is 8,000 into 7, 56,000 according to our example. Out of 7, all shareholders had paid the amount except me. I had purchased 400 share, the 400 into 4, 1600. So out of called up capital, 56,000, you have to deduct 1,600. It becomes 54,400. This is called paid up capital. Sixth one is unpaid capital. Unpaid capital, or sometimes it is called uncalled capital. Now this is the amount which company has not demanded. For example, right now there is no need of 3 rupees for the company. Company does not need these 3 rupees. इस 3 रुपए की अभी कंपनी को जरूरत नहीं है. तो दे आर नॉट डिमांडिंग दिस 3 रुपीज फ्रॉम शेयर होल्डर. वेन टाइम कम्स दे विल डिमांड दिस 3 रुपीज. वेन दे नीड मनी दे विल डिमांड, दे विल सेंड नोटिस इन एडवांस टू द शेयर होल्डर्स दैट वी नीड 3 रुपीज, प्लीज ट्राई टू सेंड दिस 3 रुपीज बाई द एंड ऑफ दिस एंड दिस मंथ. या एक पर्टिकुलर डेट दे दिया जाता है और नोटिस भेजते हैं एडवांस में कि आपको ये 3 रुपए भेजने हैं. लेकिन अभी करंट में इस 3 रुपए की कंपनी को कोई जरूरत नहीं है. तो दे आर नॉट डिमांडिंग द अमाउंट आउट ऑफ टोटल सब्सक्राइब्ड कैपिटल विच इज नॉट डिमांडेड बाई द कंपनी, विच इज नॉट डिमांडेड बाई द कंपनी, दैट इज कॉल्ड अनपेड कैपिटल और अनकॉल्ड कैपिटल. एंड देन सेवेंथ वन इज रिजर्व कैपिटल. रिजर्व कैपिटल this called uncalled capital, then reserve capital. Uncalled capital and then reserve capital. What is reserve capital? Company has not demanded this 3 rupees from the investors right now. Company ने ये 3 रुपये अभी फिलहाल नहीं मांगे investors से. जब जरूरत होगी तब मांग लेंगे. इसका मतलब क्या है? They had, means company had kept this 3 rupees reserved for future problems. When future problems comes, when they need money, that time they will demand. That's why uncalled capital is also known as reserve capital. ये जो पैसे हैं 3 रुपये, this is called reserve capital. Means total share कितने खरीदे लोगों ने, 8,000 into 3, total 24,000 rupees is called reserve capital. Means when company demands in future, that time we have to pay. Till then, it is considered as reserve capital. जब जरूरत होगी तब मांग लेंगे. लेकिन by chance, उससे पहले, मांगने से पहले, if company goes into liquidation, मतलब company बंद हो जाती है, in that case, this reserve capital becomes liability for shareholders. Means at the time of liquidation, अगर company के ये पैसे मांगने से पहले ही company बंद हो जाती है किसी reason से, then all shareholders has to pay. It is compulsory for all shareholder to pay this 3 rupees. Means this 3 rupees, this reserve capital becomes liability for shareholder. They have to pay this 3 rupees. Means total shares are purchased by investors 8,000 into 3, 24,000. All investors have to pay this 24,000 to the company because they are owner of the company. So at the time of liquidation, reserve capital must be paid by the shareholder. So these are the different types of share capital. So according to textbook, authorized share capital is given, issued share capital, subscribed share capital, then called up share capital, then paid up share capital, and I have explained 2 additional points, uncalled capital and reserve capital. So this portion is deleted from the course, that's why leave it. In next lecture, we'll try to complete this chapter, and topic is dematerialization of share, and last one is various issue to issue share. Page number 132 and page number 133 you have to do, only 2 topics. So in next lecture, we will try to complete this chapter.